which aquaponic system is the best. This is what we're going to see together in this video. So when we talk about aquaponics, we talk about the fact that growing an ecosystem with plants and fish, and obviously in the middle we got bacteria. That's the general idea of aquaponics. But then when you want to put this in application, you got different options. You can grow plants and fish in what we call a growbed, flood and drain growbed aquaponics, such as the one I have behind me. That's the backyard option. Then you can go for NFT, which is nutrient film technique. It's when we grow food inside pipes with holes, and in those pipes we got some plants that are growing, the roots are in the pipes, and you got a film of water that is coming from the fish tank into those pipes, and therefore you got all the nutrients that are there and the plants are growing from those pipes. And finally, you got the deep water culture, or also known as the raft technique, because you got big and long tanks, and on those tanks you got some rafts of polystyrene foam, and on this you got some plants that are growing with the roots that are falling in the water underneath, and this water is coming also from the fish tank, so it's very high in nutrients. So those three techniques, they are all very interested, and the aim of this video is to tell you which one is the best one. But to be very honest, there is no best one. There are just few that are more adapted to some specific use than others. The reason why behind me we got only growbed aquaponic systems, so flood and drain growbed aquaponic systems, is because those setups, they are very well adapted to backyard aquaponics. They can be very small. You have the fish in the tank just underneath. On the growbed you got your plants and your bacteria. And yeah, that's the key. You got all the bacteria that are living on a media. So you see that this media here. And this media, it's just a volcanic rock. It's the growbed here is full of this media, and all those bacteria that are living on the media, they're going to transform the fish waste into plant fertilizer. That's really the key in aquaponics. In a flood and drain growbed aquaponics, you are always sure that you got a good surface area for your bacteria. And for me, this is the key, because this is not something that you're going to find in, for example, NFT, nutrient film technique, because in those pipes, the bacteria are mainly growing on the roots of the plants. So if for some reason you got your plants that die, then you have no bacteria left for your fish, which means that all the bacteria are gone, then the fish, you're going to continue to feed them. And if the fish continue to eat, they're going to release some waste in the water, and those waste are not going to be transformed because there are no bacteria anymore, which means that the fish, after a while, they're going to be in a toxic environment and they may die. You don't have this problem in a classic backyard aquaponics such as this one, because even if all my plants die, I still have all this surface area for the bacteria, so I always got a good filtration for my plants. The nitrate level may increase slowly. I will be able to manage that by changing a bit of water if I have to, really, if I am in really bad situation. But what I'm trying to say is that the backyard aquaponics, the flood and drain growbed aquaponics, is really, really well adapted to little scale aquaponics. And then if you go for big scale, the best system is probably the deep water culture, and then you can have hybrid systems, because the deep water culture helps you to grow some plants on rafts, and they are very easy to manage. Every week you can remove some rafts and collect the plants. So harvest the plants and put new rafts in the system with new seedlings. So very easy to manage. And therefore those systems are extremely well adapted to big scale aquaponics. So as you may have understood right now, there is no good system or bad system. But what I really recommend is, if you are starting aquaponics and if you are a beginner, is to start with the flood and drain growbed aquaponics. This is the most adapted to backyard aquaponics. And if you are interested by those type of systems, you can have a free training from the description of the video just below. It's a training when I give you a lot of information, critical information, to build your own aquaponic system in the good conditions, and also to avoid to make the mistakes that we see very often, and to allow you to manage it in the best conditions. So you will have access to this free training from the description of the video just below, or in the I like information on the corner of the video. So right now, that's if you are in a backyard aquaponics, and that's what I recommend to build some experience, even if you have the project to later on go for big scale. But if you already build a strong experience on those type of setup, and if you have a large surface, then you can go for other type of systems such as the nutrient film technique, NFT, or the deep water culture, DWC, where there it's really well adapted to big scale aquaponics and to fast production, because you have less labor, you don't have to plant the new plants or do those type of things. It's very simple, you just put new plants on some pots in rafts, hop, and you collect the old ones. Same for the NFT, it doesn't take so much room and you can produce a significant quantity of food. So those two last systems, they are really good for bigger scales. But again, I wouldn't be able to say one is better than the other. It just depends on exactly what you want to do with aquaponics and what is your level of experience. But to begin, again, if you are beginning in aquaponics, my recommendation is to start with a flood and drain growbed aquaponics, and you can always then add some other type of systems such as a nutrient film technique link to this fish tank that is existing. So then you have an NFT plus a growbed linked to the fish tank that is existing. So you have a hybrid system that is very strong then. And later on, you can go for deep water culture if you wish to. So if you enjoyed this video and if you want to learn more about aquaponics, I recommend you to subscribe to the channel. I release one new video every week to help you to build some serious knowledge about aquaponics and to grow some sustainable, healthy and tasty food in your own backyard. Also, don't forget to give a like to the video, and I see you in the next one. Bye bye. Don't forget to get your free gift from this screen. You can also leave me a comment below the video, subscribe to the channel, and see my last video. I really hope to see you soon, and I wish you a fantastic success with aquaponics. Have a good crop!